to O'Day on the Rift.
Thank you very much, Quickshot. What's up, guys? Joined by Doublelift and Nien of Counterlogic Gaming. So first things first, the fountain dive for the pentakill. Was that your idea?
No, I was actually the only person on the team who didn't want to do it because I was scared we were going to throw the game. And I was just like, I already got a bunch of pentas before. Why do we need to do this? Right here, we're just talking like, oh, or the team fight comes out and I'm scared that I'm going to die right here. So I have to flash over the wall. And so I flash and I'm like, oh, Dominate's like right in front of me. This is perfect. I can reset because that's what Jinx is for in team fights. You just get the reset. And then right here, Afro's like, yo, click my lantern. And I'm like, what? You're 2 feet away. And then he flashes forward. And I was like, oh, that was sick. So go for Bunny. That's like a free kill. I got a triple kill. And then right here, everyone's screaming, Penta, Penta, Penta. And I was like, what are you talking about? They're in their fountain. And then everyone on my team was telling me, let's do it. And I said, no, I don't want to do it. I started hitting the turret because I was so scared.
And I just run straight for it.
Yeah. And then when I get the quad right here, everyone's just like, do it, do it, do it. And I actually... we almost didn't end the game right there because Renekton was like 1 inch away from stunning me and potentially like stopping me from killing their Nexus, but they didn't do it. Yeah, I don't really seek the glory anymore, but my team wants me to get the Penta, so I love them.
It's very selfless of them. I think even if you lost that game, you could just say worth it, and we would give you the 2-0 anyway.
Yeah.
I think that's how we'd take care of this one. So, Nien, I actually want to talk to you a little bit because... there's a big fan outcry very recently. You've been getting some criticism early in the playoffs, and then everyone's like, guys, Nien's awesome. How does it feel kind of coming in that match with a big backing there for you?
It feels good. In recent times, I've been on the hate train pretty hard, so it's really nice seeing people support me and seeing that people still do support me, and I really appreciate that. But ultimately, it's my fault for not performing as well as my team, so... I just need to perform better in the future, and I won't get as much hate. So,
anything to say to the fans who are kind of there for you?
But just like I said before, just thank you guys very much for supporting me. I really do appreciate it, and I hope you guys still support me in the future.
Okay, so let's actually talk about then how this game went down. Nice, you got an extra bit of applause there from the audience. Always wonderful. Okay, so let's talk about this game as it went down. It seems like sort of the postseason for CLG started out high, dipped down, then came back really strong at the end, especially in this series. Mm-hmm. Were you sort of regaining confidence when you were fighting against Curse? Because game two seemed so just devastating the whole time.
Yeah, the first game, we made a lot of mistakes. Generally, like, it's a bad idea to fight against Assassins, and especially to fight against Renekton at Drag. And when they have double Assassin Renekton, it's just like a big no-no. You just like don't fight a drag. We just got into the position where like Morgue hit a really good bind on, I think it was Akali. And we were like, let's go, let's go. And when you lose a team fight like that, it really sets you far behind. And you don't want to take any more risks. It's really hard to find that line where like, oh, now we can fight them 5v5. Because we were coming back from that like 1-4 fight, I think it was. Mm-hmm. And we were just like, okay, we just have to wait till probably 30 or 35 minutes. And it's really easy for us to win 5v5 against Assassins when it comes late game. Because I'm playing Lucian, really safe AD, really good scaling. And I smashed Kopp in lane. So he's never going to get the scale into like 6-item Caitlyn. It was just a sloppy game by us. But then the second game, we're just like, okay, we know what we did wrong the first game. We didn't listen to our plan. And our plan was don't fight them at Dragon. And this game, actually, I think our plan was the same. They still had Renekton, so it's like, don't fight them at Dragon, but they just fed us a bunch of kills, so we just snowballed.
Well, speaking of getting fed a couple of kills, I want to bring up another replay, actually. It's a mid-game team fight there in the mid lane. Afromu gets like an awesome initiation. We can get that one up there. Nien, if you want to walk us through this sort of a battle. Actually, this might be the one where Dexter got caught, sorry.
Oh yeah, this is actually a clip of Dexter getting caught.
Yeah, Dexter is just calling for help right now, so we start to rotate down to help him. We realize Link spawned him, so we don't really want to fight too much, but we know that we can if they're at misposition. And we get the free kill on Kha'Zix here, and me and Link are... Link hasn't started rotating yet, but I'm about to be here, and Link's going to rotate soon. So we know that we can just go on them really, really soon. And I'm about to flash over and ulti on three of them. I force two of the flashes, get on the Caitlyn, and the backline's doing absolutely nothing right now. Renekton's about to die. So we just clean up the fight from here after the backline's useless.
Yep. When your tank flashes forward and your backline flashes back, it's either going to be a team wipe for sure from either side. Okay. That's guaranteed. Because like, especially against reset champions and really fast champion cleanups or cleanup champs like Lulu, if Renekton doesn't kill us both, then I get the reset and then their whole team dies.
And so that's like basically a snap judgment call to say, are we the stronger team right now? And basically, all right, well, one of us is going to win the fight for sure at this point.
Yeah. And Dexter was right then blaming Afro because he's like, where's my lantern or something like that. It was pretty funny.
It came down. He got stunned too much. Yeah. It was there. He just didn't click it. It's his own fault. Mm. Okay, so I want to talk to them about what happened in your tournament here, because you guys had, you know, a great showing against Coast overall, 2-0. That went really nicely. TSM, game one started so well for you guys. Game two started well and then dipped. Like, what happened to you guys that had you falter?
You can go first.
Wait, sorry. What was the question?
Yeah, sorry.
I was distracted by something.
Yeah, there was a chant for one of the teams or something. I don't know why, but so your match against TSM, right? Mm-hmm. Game one, completely awesome by you guys. Crushing victory. You guys did wonderful. Game two started well and then dipped, and it seems like you didn't recover in game three either. And then the curse game kind of started slow as well. What happened that made you guys kind of dip down for a while?
After the first game, we were all feeling really confident. We knew that we could win the series. And then after the second one, we had the game pretty much as long as we didn't throw, but then we ended up throwing. And that really crushed everyone's morale, I think, and going into the game three. And for me, myself, personally, I spent like 40 games in solo queue practicing jacks, like 15 games in scrims in the past week. So I was like ready to carry, and my team trusted me to carry with the first big jacks, but I let myself down when my team down wasn't able to carry. And so I was personally feeling kind of bad. And then also there was like a ward jump that failed. Yeah. I'm not sure if that's an intended mechanic or a game mechanic, but that kind of also sucked. And I was pretty salty about that. So the combination of those things.
That's fair.
Going to game three.
So then how'd you come back after the game three, the loss then, coming into third place match? You guys 2-0'd it. How'd you recover and get ready for this game?
There's just a really big skill difference between TSM and Curse. Honestly, if we played another best of three against TSM, I don't think we'd like be so down that we wouldn't put up a good fight. I think it would still be 1-2 either way again, you know? And when we go up against Curse, it's a new day. It's a fresh day. And we know that Curse is a lot weaker than TSM. So it's not like, especially their dual lane. I was really looking forward to 2v2ing Curse's dual lane. And it was really fun.
It went well for you guys. You guys had a very big lead on that game. So then let's talk about sort of, you said that, you know, you guys would likely put up a very good fight against TSM. You guys were almost in the finals. Looking back in the season, does this go kind of as you expected? Obviously, you would hope for a top two finish, but tell me your thoughts about the season so far then for you guys.
I'd say we've met expectations for me. I thought that we definitely make top. Well, we didn't really meet expectations. I thought that we could place first, but we got top three, which is really, really good for CLG and for us, of course, because we are CLG. And
yes,
it's just really, really good for the improvement that we've made in the past few months. So I'm really happy about that.
Yep. I think it was really optimistic for us to go from I think we were fifth place last season to top two this season. We did have a horrible start to the season, which I think really affected us. We didn't get to practice with our main roster for 2 weeks or 3 weeks. I'm pretty happy with how things went. Obviously, disappointment comes because, you think, you get all hyped up. You're like, wow, we can win this. We're one game away from making it to grand finals, right? And then, all CLG fans and everyone on the team is just, we're crushed. But I'm still happy with how things went. You know, top three is, it's our best so far, it's our highest standing in LCS so far in three seasons. So I'm happy about that.
Okay, so one last question for you, Doublelift. You're actually going to be heading to Paris in about a week and a half. You're top two in the fan vote, and of course, TSM, Cloud9 in the grand finals there means anyone in the top three is going as well. So Midas will join you in one capacity or the other. How do you feel going into this event to represent as an individual player?
Well, I would just want to showcase NA and NA's skill and my skill too. So I hope that the games will be I'll be able to just play normal. You know what I mean? I don't really want to play too much ARAM or random stuff. I just want to play a somewhat normal game. I know it's not going to be exactly 5v5 Summoner's Rift. I know it's a Hexakill or something, but I'm looking forward to making NA look good. That's my ultimate goal. When I go to Paris, I'm just I hope that the rest of the world doesn't think NA is such a joke, because we really aren't. And I think if C9 goes, I think they have a really great shot at performing against other top worldwide teams. And NA, me and Meteos are definitely world class.
What if TSM goes? They won't represent?
TSM has historically not really performed against, especially Korea. Maybe they'll be able to do well against EU and China. We'll see. They're really strong right now, especially Bjergsen.
I think they would do good. I think.
Yeah.
All right. So a little bit of camaraderie there. More so from Nien. Doublelift, hit and miss. It's okay.
What?
That's fine. Sorry. All right. Well, we'll see these guys, of course, play in a week and a half. But guys, thank you for your time. Congratulations on the third place finish. We'll see you guys next split. We're going to take a quick break. But when we come back, it's our next big matchup, Cloud9 versus Team Solo Mid. The teams are in the building. They're